Hello and welcome, my name is Nilos and this is episode 105 of our Let's Play campaign of Factorio. As we're looking at this is the rocket silos, the two rocket silos that I expect to use for my rocket launching. What we have up here, I may have gone through it in a previous episode, is a small little setup that has not been started producing that consists of where I place the iron cannon, over the iron cannon, and here I make the satellites. So what I've actually thought about, so the previous episode we created something. Something up here, maybe? Yeah, up here. We created lots and lots of. Are they actually not creating? Let's see how much. Nope, I have all the engines I need, electric engines. And a lot of these as well. I wonder how many I have. Okay, I have 4.8k of of electric engines, so that's gonna cover it. I have. What else do we have here? Where are my turrets? Laser turrets? I think I should have a lot of laser turrets. What am I? I wonder if I set them to. Why do I not see any laser turrets though over there? Because it's less than 1,000, maybe like 500 or so. In any case, let's go down here. So one of the things that I really wanted to do here is that if I start filling these up with what they request, I'm gonna get in trouble. So I wanted to make sort of an override. This one is now set to create 5. This one is set to create 1. But I'd like to have an override that shuts both the inputs and outputs. And the way I want to do that is by, for this one, so this one, for example, is set to produce only when the amount of orbital iron cannons requested is more than 1. And it is currently 5, or it's actually more than 0. So what if I took this one and set orbital iron cannon minus 1000? Then if I fed it into the same network like that, actually, I don't want to do that, but that becomes obvious afterwards or later. There, so I fed it into here. I would now add minus 1000 plus the 5. So it'll definitely not produce. You can see it switched off to a small red icon there. That means it is disabled. If I now press F, then I shut it off and this turns green. So by pressing this one with F, I can switch that on and off. However, if I switch this off, it'll still continue building at least 2 more and buffer it. And I don't want that. So what I do is actually I link this to all of the inserters. So we'll immediately stop inserting everything or anything and as well as outputting anything. So it'll, that's the closest thing as a stop. I could actually hook up the power, but now I'm doing this. So this one, it needs a slightly different logistic here. It actually needs to be greater than minus 1 because this one is not fit the input side of things. It is only fed this signal, which is either going to be 0 or 1000. So if it's 0, I want it to be enabled. If it's minus 1000, I don't want it to be enabled. So I can now copy this around and you can see that they are now enabled. If I press this one, they all turn red. So that works. So I can use this one to enable, which means that if I do this now, I can set up the requesters, but it will not start shoving it in because I don't want it to shove it in before I choose to. Now let's also do the same over here, just for satellites. It basically means I have an override available on site here that I can use to override inputs. So I can stop them immediately because they are consuming a lot of materials and I don't want them to consume it all the time. I want to do a trial run now just so we get an idea about how things are working, where the bottlenecks are. Greater than or less than minus 1. Greater than minus 1, of course, obviously. And everything is turned off. And now everything is turned on. Yes. So we want to leave things off. We don't want it to accidentally produce. This one is also off. Now everything is off here. Let's start doing a request here. So I have 8 items that I need, and let's have a look at the numbers. It's 100. The accumulators is the worst one. I have not sped up any of the accumulators, so we're going to run out of those pretty fast. Processing units, probably also run out of that. I'm basically going to take twice the amount of every single one in the requester. So that's going to be 200. And I want each of them dedicated. So this one is 200. This next one is solar panels. How many solar panels? Also 200 solar panels. Next one is accumulators. I need 200, so that's going to be 400 accumulators. That's a lot. And next one is radar. How many? 10 radar. So let's request 20 radar. I'm not sure I actually have 20 radar. You know, these are the kind of things I want to see where it breaks first, and that's where we need to start putting our effort in. What's this one? Accumulators? I'm going to explain why that's already run out. Let's see, what was that one up here? This is processing units. I need 200 processing units. Oh, that sucks. That's going to be 400 of those. So this is not a matter of, it's not a speed test for the megabase. This is a matter of just getting a few so we get the feel of it. It's 50 electric engines. And also get a few of these in so we can start blasting the biters. Yes, thank you, autosave. And how many laser turrets? Laser turrets, 50. Wow. Laser turrets, 100 of those. And the last one is rocket fuel. We need 100 rocket fuel requested. That belongs over here. Rocket fuel, 100. Excellent. But none of it is actually putting things in. This one is not working. Let's actually have a look at why this is not working. Yeah, let's look at the aroma. This is why it's not working. As you can see here, oh no, that's so annoying. I know what the problem is. It is that one. Why is that one? It is not placing the stuff it should be, because the robot can't access it. I think there's missing a robot port there. There's a robot port there that should actually give access to all of these issues. But there's missing one robot port, and there's missing one robot port, and I don't know why that one is not bridging the gap, or any of these actually. Oh, right, I know, because I did not put one up here or down there. That means this area with robot port is not connected to these areas. In any case, what I have done is actually I've expanded this significantly, and that's needed. Because I'm going to need a lot of power for this. Let's have a look at the power situation. I have 87,000, getting another, not quite 10K, but maybe 3K, 4K from one of these. So our demand is quite high. Now, the reason why that one is not working is, of course, because it's filling up the stack, the slack here. So what about a normal satellite? What are you requiring? You're also requiring these. Okay, I clearly need to make some more accumulators before we can do any kind of testing here. I think we should just, let's set this up. Let's see, that's 100, 100, 100. Okay, so that's the same for 100 low density. I'm gonna request 200. 100 solar panels, I'm gonna request 200. 100 accumulators, I'm going to request 200, which will be the worst part. What else? Radar. 5 radar, that's going to be 10 radar. I'm also going to speed those up for sure later on. And next we have processing units. That's 100 processing units and 50 rocket fuel. So we're going to request 200. And we're going to request 100. Rocket fuel. That's not a rocket fuel. That one. Good thing it's something that cannot be delivered. Excellent. That's the critical one. It has 6. I know where I can get more just to speed things up and get the ball rolling. What I've also done since last episode is actually to clean up a few of the bases. The warning up here with bases that are running out has been removed, because I've deconstructed the bases. See here, like that. It's not a lot, but it is something. Do we also want this? I think we do. It's a bit of a shame that it is like that. How fast are you producing? They're producing about as fast as you would expect. However, it's just not fast enough. What is the problem? Oh, let's also enable some research. What do we want? Do we want cathode, Nixie tubes? No, I don't want any of this research, to be perfectly honest. So none of this I really want. Gun turrets? No, no. Character logistics shot. I don't really need it. There's no point in doing that except for sort of the sense of completion. Let's run back. These ones are actually working quite efficiently. You see here. These are the ones I create myself. Whoops. Because they're the ones that will feed our modules. And we still need a lot of modules here and there. Alright, let's move down here and at least get a satellite off the ground. Probably won't be able to get the other one. One, right? And you can then take the rest. Is this one doing okay? No. Is this one doing okay? Definitely not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Yep. And that one can then take the next. Good. So we're going to do it here. We're also going to do the same here, but I think I want to trigger these as well so I can stop and start these, but I'll stop and start them together. Anyway, let's see if everything else is working. This is 200, this is 200. We got everything else we needed. It's to be expected. Let's trigger this one and see if it works. So we build one satellite. It works. And it should only build one. It does take a bit of time. Why are we not even speeding this one up? Boom. Well, that's because it's really not necessary. I could actually request some of these efficiency beacons. Why not? Because I don't know if they're getting slower. So we have one. A single one. That's good. Let's build the same trigger down here. I will actually build it sort of in the middle. There. This one will go from here to here, and then go to each one of these. Can I get? Yes, I can reach. So I want to stop all inserting. It doesn't look good. That distinctly does not look good when it's overlapping, so I'm going to build it up there. Huh. Ah, shoot. That should be the red line. It really should be the red line. Because otherwise it will interfere with this. Actually, no, it doesn't. Not for now. Because I'm not actually using triggering this at this point. Here. Good. Now that's up and running for now. Let's do the same on this location. I want to make sure that I don't overproduce, or more likely, I want to make sure that I have access for it. Let's see, what icon should I use as, I think it's actually the rocket silo. Rocket silo equal one. So this one will only produce if rocket silo equal one. Seems reasonable. Rocket silo equal to one. That's when we will produce that one. Actually, I think this one will be let me just think, because I want to be able to trigger one or both. So this one is, if I trigger one, then means one of them start. If I trigger two, then both of them start. So this one should be, should not be, this should be greater than zero. So this one's always started, and the other one only starts if the value is 2. Good. And these over here, they are starting. Let's actually copy paste it over so we can tell. This is only when it's greater than 1. Copy. We paste it all the way around. Good. Like this. Let's see, these are now disabled, these are enabled. If I take this value equal to 2, then I have both active. So I'm going to actually set it to 1 because I only want one active at this point. And this is where, let's just do this one, Nixie tubes, that's a different display icon. Yep, there we go. And let's try building one. Then I can trigger this and feed it in. What are you doing? You are enabled when rocket silo is greater than 0. Great, so that's equal to 1. Maybe I should actually use colors. Ah, I did not know that one worked with colors. Can we also set a color then? Why not? Pink? Hey, that's not pretty. that does not look correct. Okay, there we go. 1. Okay, so I know how many silos are actually working at this point, or operational. I might build more, you never know. And then I want to control it here. So that one is enabled, that has produced 1, because the setup is only saying produce 1, because I can easily produce 1 more as needed. Let's set up this one for requesting. And at that point, I want to set this one to disabled, because now I can request it. So this one will be requesting. Yes, come on. Satellites. Just get 2 satellites. Why not? Okay, that's 2 satellites. There we go. That's produced pretty fast. I will actually, I just want 1, right? For now, I just want a single one. This one is requesting how much? Should we just say 1,000 in each? Because why not? It is, yeah, it's equal amounts. So this one will be rocket fuel. It is too much I carry here. It's way too much, actually. I'm going to consider that. Let's take 200 instead. Yeah, there. Well, it is what it is. And these over here, that will be rocket control units. There you go, 200. Yeah, this is more like it, except it's not 200 anyway. So if we just click this one, then we want to see what we get. It works. Let's have a look at this one. Yeah, it's pretty fast. It's an okay speed. It's nothing impressive. I should have something, a launch thingy. That one should trigger launch 1 rocket per scanning cycle. There we go. That is the first rocket launch. Let's stand here, because we're definitely gonna take a screenshot of this for the thumbnail. Here we are. Let's see if it launches itself. That one should be launching. See, scanning. I don't want to touch it. It's not launching. Come on. Why are you not launching? Oh, it is. Great. Awesome. There we go. And now we get the depressing number of hours played. 65 hours on this map. I'm not done yet, right? That's a crappy place it's positioned. But then it continues. Oh, then I'm gonna disable you, because I don't want, see, there we go. It stops immediately. Still going pretty fast, this one, but it doesn't complete. Great, excellent. It's quite a decent speed. Now let's actually, what I am concerned about is this one, because I don't want to be feeding these. I also want a control here that says rocket or cannon. I don't know how to, maybe I should build that rocket or cannon. That it could be something I can build here. Let's see how I want to do that. I'm gonna definitely build it with these. So I'm gonna write rocket. No, that doesn't work. No, satellite. I think that's correctly spelled. And the other one will be ion cannon. Nope, like this, and there. And then I'm gonna put a light for each of these. Well, that's, well, it's not quite what I wanted. And I just want to indicate which one is active. And between that, I'll have this one, right? And I should also, well, first it's, let's see how do I want to do this? Okay, I want to just, this one outputs ion cannon. That means I want an ion cannon. So that links into this one with a green icon. Yes, and that one says when ion cannon. Let's see. When the ion cannon is equal to 1. Use color. There. Now I'm gonna do a silly one here. And this one will be when it is greater than 1. No, when it's equal to 0. Right, so if I press this one, then I'm gonna remove the coloring. There, right? And that signal will actually need to be a red signal because I don't want to disrupt it. Let's see. That will need to go down here next to it. And no. Here, request. You're going to request 1 rocket ion cannon. Great. And I need the green wire to expand. There. Okay, so this one is outputting when that one is 1. I want to request it, but I can't, not just now. That's okay. I don't know if I have gathered enough up here. Not quite. I have 244. That's enough for 1. So let's enable this one. I do that here. Enable. It's filling up. And let's disable it again. And then I want to drag this icon. I'm going to disable this because I want the red instead. Because I want the red one to go down here into these two. Oh crap. I'm gonna need some logic. Yeah. Then I'm gonna make some logic here. Let's see. If, so what I want to do, I want to say this one is active when, let's see. I know I can do this. I know I can do this even on the fly. Copy that one and these two go away. So I'm going to take the input from here. I'm also going to take the green one that comes from wherever. Good. So I'm going to take the green one from here, also input. So this is now getting input signal is 1 orbital ion cannon. Then I'm going to output this one should be, I'm going to link this one with the green there. So this one is when there's a green signal. Let's just say it. When the green signal equals to 0, we go. Yes. So we will make it green when, okay, what's the input? When everything 2 gigs each? No, I don't want each, actually. I want everything. Basically, when the input is 2. No, this is actually when... Okay, let's see. This is when the satellite icon, satellite times the rocket, that one. It's going to be an arithmetic. Wasn't that what I did? Okay, this is satellite. Satellite times the rocket here, and that's output as a green signal. Then that one is, so basically what I'm doing now is saying that one's going to be a rocket icon or rocket silo there, this one. Right now the output is 0, so that one's not going to go. Yes, it's good. And that goes into that one. Then I'm going to take another arithmetic from this side and say when it's going to be basically the same here, except it's the ion cannon times that. Now this case it is nothing is input. Well, obviously because I'm not hooking it up and also not hooking the green one up there. So now that's, there's nothing input, there's no input here. And that goes over there. This one is going to be the same, so that's when the green icon is, should just be greater than 0. Right, so what I'm doing is, when this is 1, it's going to be 1 times 1. When this is 1 and this is 1, it outputs 1 green, but not otherwise. Right now the input is 1 of these. That one does not have an input. That is obvious because that one goes, it'll go over there. That's fine. So that one has one of these. Let's try enabling it and see how it goes. So if I enable this one, check. Let's see, what is this one? This is outputting green, so that one's active. That one's outputting red. This one is not giving anything, and that one's green. So, holy shit, that's fast. That's not what I wanted. Yeah, but you are. I wonder if it launches without anything in it. I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Dear, that one. That also needs to be enabled. I'm going to almost wrap it up. So you're going to work, and that one was import here. Oh, there's one. Let's see if that launches automatically. There, that was the scanning icon. Oh, it is launching automatically. So that's my first ion cannon. So it works. I have now put logic so that I can enable and disable. I'm going to disable that one. And up here, I can control rocket launch without the satellite. Okay. Okay. But I launched the rocket here. That's nice. Look at that. I got an ion cannon. Each ion cannon has its own cooldown. It takes time to set. Blah, 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 blah. You may create a targeting device. Yes, that's kind of what we're going to do later on. So just to recap, we now have a switch between what we want to create. Yes, no. Why is that one not switching? Off. On, off. Huh, maybe that F button is not working anymore because that one is... suddenly that stopped working. What about you? No, it's working. That one just doesn't work. Oh, there it is. Now it's working. Great. So the switch between satellite and ion cannon, we have a switch between... That should actually be a switch, but it isn't. Whether it's, I mean, 1, 2, or 0. I can switch between 0 and whatever is active with the press of a button. Down here, we have the input that comes from up here, whether we want to launch satellites or ion cannons. That's it. We now have some controls to steer this one on, and we also have these to enable and disable the creation of respectively rockets. But that's not really needed. I might as well just give it free. Oops, there. And that one as well. Might as well just enable it. Yep, that one is full. That one is, has put in whatever it can. And that's where we're gonna round off. So thank you very much for joining. We now have the rocket launching in progress. And yeah, let's see where we go from here. Thank you very much for joining, and I'll see you next time. Bye.